But because they're not a real alcoholic, they don't have to do the same work that we have to do. All right? Yet this guy may think he's a real alcoholic because he was such a high drinker. He had to go through the detox and everything, right? But let's say he only goes through a few of the steps. And then he hangs around for another 10 years, 15 years. And he says, ah, I only did steps 1, 2, and 3. I stayed sober. You know, you don't have to listen to that shit. You don't have to do that. You know, this is some of these alluring shortcuts that I've heard. You know, bypass, looking for that easiest, softer way. Me being that lazy guy saying, oh, yeah? And I met a guy like this in Connecticut. There was a guy in one of the groups I went to up there. He said he had 23 years and only did steps 1, 2, and 3. Hey, I would like, you know, I would like nothing more than to do steps 1, 2, and 3 and be done with it. You know? And be happy. Yeah, but guess what? Like, you, I saw you mouth the words, half measures. Yeah, half measures offered us nothing, right? Accomplished nothing, you know? Availed us nothing. That's the word they use. Availed us nothing. Half that effort, I don't get half the result. I get zero of the result. You know, so if I am a real alcoholic coming into these meetings, and I'm hearing people, you know, and I hear people say, ah, I don't have to do this, or I don't have to do that, you know, there are no rules, there are no musts in AA, you know, you can do whatever, and things like that. I might be tempted to follow those people. And in fact, I had followed those people before because I had never read this book. I never understood what was in this book and what this book was trying to tell me, you know. And I ended up for 8 years coming to AA, you know, that's something else I hear, meeting makers make it. Yeah, well, for 8 years, I went to meetings. I was making meetings, not as many as I should have probably, but I was going to meetings on a regular basis, and I was not getting sober. How come? Well, I wasn't following the directions in the book, you know. I was looking for that easier, softer way. So where they're cautioning the family that, you know, yeah, there's work involved in this way of life, but we got to make sure that we as the alcoholic are aware of that same caution, you know. There will be alluring shortcuts and bypaths down which they may wander and lose their way. You know, when I go down there and I lose my way, what do I have to do? It says that God doesn't make too hard terms with those that seek Him. You know, if I'm really sincere about this thing, you know, I ask God to help me back out of it. He picks me up and sends me back on my way, you know. And so I can once again become recovered, you know, and work on that that spiritual fitness on a daily basis. Here, look what they're going to go on here, you know. It says, suppose we tell you some of the obstacles a family will meet, all right? So they're going to let us know what we may be in for. Suppose we suggest how they may be avoided. That's a good idea, huh? Even converted to good for use for others. Converted to good use for others. The family of an alcoholic longs for the return of happiness and security. They remember when father was romantic, thoughtful, and successful. Today's life is measured against that of other years, and when it falls short, the family may be unhappy. Okay, so now, again, here's the family trying to deal with this guy. He's just starting into recovery. He's convalescing, you know, and they want him to be just like he was 20, 30, I don't know, however many years ago, right? They've got this thing, this image stuck in their head. And probably like the way I do it with my resentments, how I keep rolling it over, it gets bigger and distorted and twisted. And, you know, it may not even be the real thing that I saw at the time, but that they've got this, and they're measuring Dad up against this from years ago. All right? It says, family confidence in Dad is rising high. The good old days will soon be back, they think. Sometimes they demand that Dad bring them back instantly. Instant. Dad, get better right now, or what? Or else what? You know, I don't know. I got a note here. It says, you see page 116. I'm not sure what that's referring to. Last paragraph on page 116, you know. And this is the chapter we just finished, to wives. It says, this last chapter says, at first, some of us did not believe we needed this help. We thought on a whole we were pretty good women, capable of being nicer if our husbands stopped drinking. But was it a silly idea that we were too good to need God? Now we try to put the spiritual principles to work in every department of our lives. When we do that, we find it solves our problems too. The ensuing lack of fear, worry, and hurt feelings is a wonderful thing. So here again, you know, that The wives, in the chapter, the wives, they're trying to make use of these steps, trying to do the same thing, all right? Here, well, the family is trying to do the same thing, and we, the alcoholics, we've been trying to do the same thing. And as alcoholics, I know I can get very impatient. And when I wasn't getting what I wanted, you know, I get all frustrated. It takes time to realize that, you know, it tells me I got to quit playing God, it didn't work. It takes time for me to realize that I got to stop putting demands on God and stop waiting for God to let me know what He's going to do. You know, step 11 says, you know, I start through prayer and meditation, seeking out His guidance for me. Yes, Joanne.
You want to know why? Because everything in life takes time, and that concept took me 6 years to grasp alone. So that's really saying something, because everything in life does take time.
And that's kind of what I'm referring to here. You know, when I seek out God's help, unfortunately, it all happens in God's time rather than Bill's time. You know, I tell people nowadays that, you know, because of the way I was brought up, I never had any trouble believing that there was a God. I just got to the point where I didn't have any use for Him anymore, because I had told Him to do so many things so many times, and He didn't do it. I said, the hell with it. Why even bother with Him? You know?